For more such videos, subscribe to Jagran Josh and press the bell icon to never miss a new video from Jagran Josh.
Hi, so my name is Sumanta Basu. I'm in the Operations Management Group of IIM Calcutta, and I'm here for around 10 years. Currently, I'm also chairing the admissions office of IIM Calcutta, and as IIM Calcutta is coordinating the CAT examination this year, I'm also convening the CAT on behalf of CAT committee. So as long as we have received, so as the application window finished last night, so we have received total number of completed applications along with completed payment is more than 2.41 lakhs. So it's higher than whatever we have received last year, which is approximately in the range of 2.3 lakhs. So there is an increase definitely, but this count is before we check the duplicate applications. So this is as of now the number of applications which we have received. We are really not favor of changing the examination pattern altogether. What we seek is to develop an exam that kind of understands the managerial capability and the analytical thinking of the candidates, and hence we are looking for more fundamental issues related to the questions instead of really changing the pattern altogether. And we have analyzed the results of the last year's CAT, and accordingly the concerned committee found suitable recommendations, and we are working in this manner. But yes, we are not changing the pattern, and that does not mean that we are changing the complexity altogether. We have more focus on the fundamental of every question instead of changing the pattern. Yeah. If you follow CAT closely, and the CAT syllabus closely rather, primarily the syllabus contains the topics which are there till class 10. So in a way the syllabus assigned for CAT examination creates a level playing field both for engineers and non-engineers. Now, regarding the examination pattern or the question type, we have said we do not want any question to be biased towards engineer. That does not mean the difficulty level will change and so on, but the problem context should be familiar for you know, both for engineers as well as non-engineers. So the non-engineers will not struggle as long as understanding the question is concerned. But analysis of the question is again your knowledge and analytical skill and the understanding that you develop till class 10 you know, syllabus is still required. So we have given a timeline till October 18th to release the information regarding this. And currently we are in process of this. We are hopeful that we'll be able to do the same as it was done in the last year. Primarily keep the fundamentals same. So do not really go for pattern too much. Find out the fundamentals behind every question and why we are trying to do that. What is the logic behind it, instead of really trying to find out a way to do this. And whatever selection is of primary importance, identifying the right question and attempting it correctly, because even if you choose a question and do it wrongly, it will only yield you negative marking for most of the questions. So two or three things that we need to do. One is selection of the question, second is attempting the question correctly, and then selection of the right option. So yeah, so that is what I suggest. Don't go for number too much, go for the right numbers, that would be the key. Last moment preparation, I mean, they're more equipped to really know what kind of pattern CAT follows. As I have said, that try to understand the fundamentals of the questions, like for example, arithmetic progression, geometric progression in arithmetic. So Those kind of subject areas, you try to see why things are happening in this manner instead of really trying to do 10 questions of similar difficulty level. Okay, so try to figure out the internal logic instead of really trying to cover a variety of the questions. I hope that would make their preparation in a more focused manner. Currently, wherever India stands, as of now, management education is concerned, I believe that it has a three-stage process. It starts with the admissions from where the input comes, then it goes to the educational institutes like IIMs and goes beyond that, and then finally participants are getting absorbed into the industry, and it's an ongoing process in that process. So, of course, as of now, we have a significant number of educational institutes that contribute to the management education, and we are able to do it successfully for the past 50 years, as is the older IIMs, and they are one of the pioneers in this education. So, where we feel is a requirement is towards the input side, and from my position, admissions play a significant role in getting the right set of candidates whom we desire to be in the management position, as long as the aspiration, analytical capability, decision-making capability, delivery point of view. So all those things are required, and everything cannot be taught in a management institute in a shorter time frame. So we need good input to the institute as well. And for that, we need good aggregator organizations who will come up and bridge this gap. There is a significant gap between whatever the input market is and whatever management education desires in India. And hopefully, if there are organizations who can come up and spread the knowledge to the prospective candidates and who are yet to be prospective but have sufficient capability and competency to be absorbed in the management field, then it would be advantageous for the nation as well as for the management education in India. So we feel that in this premise, there should be educational institutes and the educational platforms or websites who will bridge this gap in terms of there is a market potential and there is a requirement as far as the industry is concerned. So we need those knowledge aggregators along with the websites who can bridge this gap and connect to the competent and enable supply side to the demand side as the market desires. Thank you.